Hi, my name's Phil Collard. I'm 34 years old and I am the owner of The Pickled Mushroom. And you're about to see a typical day in the life of what we do here.
No, I think it's true. Well, people have mixed opinions of it. They've been mentioned in the Michelin Guide and they are in the Michelin Guide. However, I had a meal there, I had a taster menu. And it was dreadful, but then I spoke to people who stand by it. But then there's one guy who I know, whose name's Matt, and he goes there all the time, but he's only ever been there on a weekend, and he went there on a weekday, the same that I went, and he was like, he called me up, and he was like, okay, I'll give it to you. He goes, garbage. I was like, why? He's like, I've just been on a weekday, and it has to be a different chef, because everything that I said about the meal, he had said, it was just bland. Yeah. Looked beautiful,
yeah,
but it was just really, really, really bland.
Where are we, Phil?
We are in Bradgate Park, which is just a big, I don't know, I guess it's a conservation, it's in Leicester.
Why this park? Why do you like to come here?
Well, for one, if you have a look around, it is massive, and the dogs absolutely love it here. There is, he's eating one of these, stop it. As you can see, there's lots of mushrooms, the dog's just eating one.
Hopefully we find some mushrooms today.
Yeah.
Why not?
Whoa. Guess who? Hey, bubba. Hey. So, this is Diablo. He's a rescue dog. Came from Loughborough. Got him at the beginning of lockdown. And this one here, the dapper one, is Picasso. And he's about almost a year old now. And I got him when, just at the end of lockdown, actually, to keep Diablo company whilst I was at work, because obviously I don't want to just leave them by themselves, and they are pack dogs. So I ended up getting the two of them.
Are they your love or your life, these dogs?
One of them is.
Which one?
Oh, I'm not going to tell you. No, they are. One's just a bit of a handful. Isn't you, mate?
This one, right,
he's,
here.
Yeah, he's still a puppy, though, so he's just got the life about him. Haven't you? No more dogs at all.
And is there any difficulty owning a business and two dogs?
Well, fortunately, at work where I'm at the moment, I've got the availability to have like a dog home for them there. So they've got a luxury chicken coop which they sit in and play around in during the day when I'm in service. And then because we live out, well, where we are at work, quite far out into the countryside, we'll just go for a little walk and a run on the split shift, and then they'll go back into the end of service. But yeah, it is difficult having the two dogs.
So if you could describe one of your dogs, or both of your dogs, how would you describe them, Phil?
Cunts. One of them. Picasso, come here. Come here. Oi. What's this? Come here. What's this? Come here. I'll let you decide which one's which. Hey, I've got some cheese, snacks. What are you fucking giving it stacks for?
So Phil, your greatest fear?
Being alone, without a doubt. Being alone and not fulfilling what I want to do. Maybe not having the family that I thought with work, but I've got the dogs in eye, so it's fine.
Deer hunting,
yeah.
With these two little.
What are you gonna do? Get him. Just kidding. No,
they'll be on someone's dinner plate soon, won't they?
It's December soon. It's culling season around here, so...
Bang, bang.
Yeah, restaurants will be getting their orders in, getting their deer shot fresh.
Do you buy venison for pickled mushroom?
Yeah, we will be this year, 100%. I know the owner that does the shooting here, specifically the shooting, so...
So you've heard it here first, the pickled mushroom selling venison this year at Christmas. Come Christmas.
Big truck, small dick.
Number plate.
Are you a calm driver, Phil?
Very, very. There's no point getting upset, is there, behind the wheel?
Second sausage.
Someone.
That's a well-written list there by the pickled mushroom.
That is a typical.
What do you think about that list? This shop gives me PTSD.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to lie to you. When I am done,
blue roll.
I will be nachos there down there. I don't need that much pudding rice.
Where are we, Phil?
In macro.
What are you doing?
Just getting everything ready. Just get ready for the weekend.
Big day.
Yep.
Big prep day. Can't wait.
Oh, it's the old list, that's
why. The price has gone up, Phil.
Yes.
I'm not happy.
Yes, not at all. It used to be £19.99. £25 for a kilo. That's £84.
Well, I load it into these boxes.
Oh, a bit messy in the back.
Fishing gear.
All the fishing gear, he don't even fish.
All the gear, but no idea.
What game is it, Phil?
It's like a giant game of Tetris.
Nice.
That's it.
Yeah, sorry. Right, Phil. There's 90,000 people, and they're all here to watch you box at Wembley. What song are you walking out to?
This one.
This song?
This one.
Sun in the sky, you know how I feel.
Everybody waiting. Everybody waiting in anticipation.
Oh, I wouldn't come out just yet.
No, you'd walk. Yeah, you'd hold.
It's a new day.
Yeah, of course, you'd be in the back.
It's a new day. It's a new life for me.
Right in the middle.
Warming myself up.
For me.
Gumshoe goes in just about now.
Gumshoe goes in now.
And I'm feeling
fist bump you. Oh, you are now. I like him, Bill.
Filling up one of the Bentleys.
Phil's got a new car. Business is going well.
No, there's like zero waste here whatsoever, but it doesn't really matter because there's zero customers, so.
Busy day prep, Phil.
Yeah, we will get everything ready now. So.
All ready for Saturday night fever?
Yep.
Perfect. Right, so I've got to leave you now, Phil. I'll let you prep. Sadly, I'm not a professional filmographer, so I've got my own shit to do, so I'll see you later for service.
Right, nice one.
Sam.
Just go.
Mini burger skin on fried single nachos.
Let's share.
We have eyes on 102, please.
Yeah, yeah. What do I?
Mushroom sauce done, chunky chips done, garlic and chili broccoli done, egg on chips.
We've got a Cali Smash and a Philadelphia cheesesteak burger.
How's the service gone, Phil?
Yeah, it's been good, mate. Thanks, yeah.
How did it begin?
So, my mum will throw her hands down and say she's the worst cook ever. Personally, I think she's the best, obviously. However, when I was younger, I used to watch Jamie Oliver, if anyone remembers The Naked Chef. If you're my age, 33 plus, you probably will remember. Used to watch Jamie Oliver, used to love cooking for my parents. They used to tell me it was lovely. It was genuinely probably the worst shit they've ever had in their lives. But they've always supported what I wanted to do, and I always wanted to be a chef. I always wanted to do my own business and push my own shit.
I had hair, yeah.
So,
what did you
cook?
No, it's a skeleton, please.
Well, I'll have a look at the rice and I'll tell you exactly
who's
wrong.
Tomorrow, yeah? No. I tomorrow going airport. I leaving my wife.
We'll
see you later.
And every time he came up in the kitchen, we were like, oh, everyone, does anyone know Zion's just come back from travelling? It could get fucking worded edgeways. Well, I do a bit of cage fighting in my spare time. And
so you only have the restaurant on then?
Only open from Wednesday through to Sunday.
And then what are you doing Monday, Tuesday?
Just do a bit of cage fighting with the lads. Nothing I really want to talk about on camera.
All right, fair enough, mate.
I haven't had a drink. I bought a drink coke and then somehow there was
in the soup. Supposed to be filming. Working. Well done, everyone. That was fucking good. That was easy as well. We made that look like we knew what we were doing. Well done. Seriously, that was fucking good work.
1,100.
No, that's not that.
What? Favourite part of the night, what is it, Phil?
Going home.
Cleaning the kitchen, getting the blue roll out, and getting this young, sexy lad to mop the floor. What's your thoughts on mopping the floor, lad?
I don't get paid for my labour.
I'll just stay at home again.
We'll leave until tomorrow.
That's what we do to him anyway.
That's what he does to me. That tells me on the day that he can't work.
Yeah.
So you can play that game.
This is the Polish worker, he works very hard.
Because he's been nice and busy for a Saturday. So, Phil.
Hello.
How do you feel about today? But first off, cheers. Because that was good fun, and I enjoyed that. So, yeah, but it's about you, so tell me.
This is Saturday for a change, obviously. Coming from macro.
Macro's a shithole.
We come in, and then we'll basically get everything out, get it all prepped up. Go through the menu, make sure we've got everything according, and then just in case waiting for people to come in, really.
We've had some bookings tonight, we had a few tables come. Disco shift, it was nice. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and appreciate you letting me come in and film you.
Anytime.
Get in your kitchen. We're probably going to be going out now for some sushi.
But yeah, as far as a normal Saturday, yeah, so it's pretty normal, no different. Sometimes might get a function, might have a few more tables booked in ahead of time, but as far as a Saturday goes, yeah, it's pretty standard.
You grew up in Bosworth? I won't ask you too much. No, you didn't grow up in Bosworth.
Grew up in Rothley.
Okay.
Then went from Rothley down to Surrey. Surrey to America. America to Glenfield. Been quite, and then Glenfield to Bosworth, which is obviously where my parents moved to. And then since then, that was when I was about 15. I'm now 33, almost 34. I've been quite nomadic with where I've been, where I've worked. This is why I've ended
and
up.
Now this is your first owning
venture.
Your own business.
Yes, yeah, my first going out and doing it myself. Yeah.
And you have any regrets?
Yeah, all of it. All of it. It's the hardest thing I've ever done. Don't become a chef. Don't do it.
Don't have your own business.
It's hard. But I've done what I wanted to do to get in.
You learn a lot from it. You learn a lot about yourself as well.
Yeah, I have. I've learned a lot about how to talk to people, how to treat people.
And sometimes, maybe even from all of this, you might even just have a small break and you might want to you might want to do it all
siesta.
Again.
I'll probably have a hiatus from this come January for a couple of months. And then come back and hit the ground running with the new business, new name, new everything.
This is it. I filmed everything. Some cooking, some cleaning. Hopefully I can portray a nice message to people and how your day was today. So yeah, cheers Phil, thank you.
See it off.
I've got to drive. Safety first, fun later, Zion.
That's very true. It's his first point, isn't it?
This was sick.
We're done. So Phil, what do you miss and what do you don't miss from working in town as you used to have for King Richard?
I miss the convenience, finishing work, coming out, having a beer, doing your own thing. But as an independent business, I don't miss having to compete with that,
with the fucking noise, the competition.
It's hard to compete with competition.
It is.
When you're a small fish in a big pond, it's hard to keep up.
Yep. The busiest place is fucking McDonald's tonight. And it ain't even selling alcohol.
As if that's all they want us to try and have a chat with them. You've been informed on tonight, but we've had to use some of our training tonight. Probably for the better, diffuse the situation, but as I said earlier, I don't like to talk about this stuff on camera, so...